First of all, it's capitalism gone mad. And secondly, why do I want to do collect a Funko Pop that's going to spend 11 months of the year in the loft? That's just going to bring you bad luck. I think that's just Thanos in a Christmas jumper. I mean, what the fuck? They're Christmas pops. It's completely Christmas-related. Be in the loft. And I think it's a... I think it's all a sellout. I don't agree. I think it's a complete sellout. I like the Batman the Scrooge. That I really like.
I have another unboxing to do for a purchase made from that auction site that I may have used a few thousand times over the last 15, 16 years. eBay, of course. This one took a little bit of haggling. It was listed as a buy it now for £20, but best offers are being accepted. According to the Funko app, this is worth relatively little, but I still wanted it. So I was prepared to go reasonably over its valuation, because its valuation at the moment is something very low, like £3 or something like that. So they weren't going to go that low when they listed it for £20. I think initially I offered £10, there was some back and forth, and then I think on the final counter offer it was £15. I accepted that, £15, and then free postage, so it's kind of like you're paying £11 really if you take postage into consideration. So 15 all in, very happy with that. Let's get this open, shall we? And for that, I of course need my trusty yellow knife. Don't waste your time on me, you're already the voice inside my head. I miss you, I miss... Don't waste your time on me. You're already the voice inside my head. I miss you, I miss you. All right. And now, let us have a sell it all. Woo! Hoping this has come in good condition. This box is pretty small, so it will have been packed tight, but no reason to suspect that it's not been well packaged, even though there looks very little sort of bump room here for this box. This is in, as so many of mine have been that I've unboxed lately, a Funko Pop that I've been getting a lot of in this collection, in this range. Still keep finding more that I want. There's some that are very expensive, unlikely to get those ever, probably, but never say never. That's my motto, especially when it comes to Funko collecting kids. This will be an invoice. It's from a company called Little Heroes, by the way. I'll try and show you that without showing my address or the details or anything, but they've got a little kind of like a Funko Pop as their brand logo there. So check out Little Heroes on eBay. And this has come in a sorter, so excellent. I think it's the actual sorter that it would have originally came with as well, looking at it. Anyway, let's get it open and I'll show you. Oh yeah, I'm sorry Frampton. You're not going to like it. But yes, I got another one. And it's Christmas time again. It is number 61 in the Fantastic Plastic line. It's original Funko creation... Jingles! Yeah! So, I'm apologising to Leroy Screwballs, because if you saw the extended intro there, you'll have been reminded, because you probably know already, he's mentioned it so often, that apart from certain exceptions, aka Batman dressed as Ebenezer Scrooge, Leroy Screwballs, while he loves Fantastic Plastic, he doesn't like pops that are overtly Christmassy. And this one is Fantastic Plastic, yet it's also quite patently Christmassy. It's got the Christmassy red, white and green Funko limited edition shop sticker on. And of course Jingles himself here is, well, is sort of a monster type Christmas bauble. Yeah, so I wasn't in any sort of great rush to get any Christmas fantastic plastic, but if you cast your mind back a week or so ago to when I did my two-part Mega Monster Pop Toys haul unboxing, there's a couple of Christmas ones. I'm looking at them now in my display here. Flaky number 14 and Igor Elf number 15, and they were brilliant price at Monster Pop Toys. I was getting some other fantastic plastic figures in that order, so I couldn't really get the others and not get those, to be honest. So then I thought afterwards, well, I want the other ones. I think there's another Christmas related guy. I think there's four of these sort of Christmas monsters altogether. Is the other one kind of like some sort of take on Santa Claus? I can't remember. I will put some sort of information or screenshot up if I find out. Well, the box looks to be in brilliant condition here, so very happy about that. And some nice artwork on the back. I will get him out briefly. All my fantastic plastic original Funko characters are in box pops, but I do like to get them out at least once to have a look. I mean, he's very diddy, as I'd expect him to be. I think that was another thing that was sort of like making me a little hesitant to get this yet. And yes, I do apologise for those who say, oh, he's doing a Christmassy unboxing, but he's also a monster, so consider it, as Blink182 might say, Halloween on Christmas, or Christmas on Halloween, whatever. It's a Funko Pop, let's not worry about the seasons. So, he's a little Christmas bauble look. He's really nice designs on him, look nice silver snowflakes. He's got this kind of top metal bit and a hook there that you would hang on your lovely pine Christmas tree or Halloween tree, if such a thing exists. He's got little legs and he's got big sort of, I would say they're kind of like elf shoes really, aren't they? They're sort of those big elf feet with the shoes with the bells on the end that curl around. And he's got like an underbite there. He's a couple of his teeth poking up from the bottom of his mouth. Lovely little guy, really. And it doesn't matter that he's Christmassy. I have Christmas-related pops displayed all year. The Christmas Vacation 2-pack, Clark Griswold and Cousin Eddie. That's just a brilliant 2-pack. That's out all year round. Flaky and Igor Alf, though they've not been in my collection very long, they will be staying out. I've got Home Alone pops. It could be argued that they don't look overly Christmassy, and I suppose they don't, but it's still a Christmas movie, so there probably would be some people out there who would only want to display those, maybe for 4 weeks of the year or a bit more. So there he is, back in his box. It's Jingles the Monster Bauble to hang on one's Christmas tree, and I suppose you could, theoretically, actually hang this on a Christmas tree, what with him having a hook. I won't be doing that. Funko do make some little Christmas tree decorations, don't they? Wouldn't be that interested in those either, but you know, if you wanted to put a full-size pop, more or less a full-size pop, up on your tree this festive period, then here we go. You heard it here first. Do it with Jingles. There are still plenty of him available on eBay, and I believe I saw him for a good price at Killer Pops as well. Thank you to all of you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And Frampton, I hope you weren't too offended at the sight of another wretched Christmas Funko Pop. Thank you to all of my amazing subscribers and patrons, as always. Please have a look at all my recommended Funko affiliate links down in the description, along with my link to my Patreon account, where you can help support me and this channel to grow as big as it can possibly be. I'm gonna go now, put Jingles here in an all things vinyl pop protector, and yes, put him permanently 12 months a year, 52 weeks, 365 days, including the leap year, blah blah blah, into my fantastic plastic wall. And I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next Funko Pop unboxing. Cheers, everyone. See ya!